Good day all, I'm Leke Oluwalogbon. I'm here to acquaint you with the field of study of political science. But let me start by introducing myself to you properly. Like I said, my name is Leke Oluwalogbon. I hold a first degree in political science from the Redeemer's University in Nigeria. I also hold a Master's of Science degree, a second degree, in political science from the University of Ibadan. I'm currently a PhD candidate also at the University of Ibadan. Political science is a field of study that majors in the studying of power relations in the state. When people hear of political science, the first thing that usually comes to mind is politics. And I've heard many people say, I don't want to be a politician, so I don't want to study political science. So I'm here to tell you that studying political science has nothing to do with being a politician. In fact, we have many politicians who have no degrees in political science. Politics is an innate ability. You understand? In fact, we are told that all humans are political animals, okay? So political science only studies power relations within the state. In other words, how humans relate when it comes to the pursuit of power, how governance is done, how policies are made, what government does, why they do not do what they do, and all sorts. So what political science does is to study all of those underlying factors behind all of those things I've mentioned. So political science is mainly a study of politics. In other words, a study of power relations, a study of what policies government made, a policy of governance, and all of such. All right? And it's a broad field that has under it some subfields. Subfields like public administration, subfields like international relations, subfields like political economy, subfields like national government and politics, like public personal administration and local government studies, and all of that. All of those are babies of political science. All right, enough of that now. If you intend to study political science, what are the basic prerequisites you need to have? Your ordinary level certificate, your ordinary level result must, of a necessity, like we have here in Nigeria, you must have a credit pass in English language. Then you must have a credit pass also in mathematics. And of necessity, you must also have a credit pass in government or history. I know nowadays there is also a third subject called civics. All right, I think it's civics, yeah. You must also have either of government, history, or civics. Okay? Then you must have credit passes in two other social science subjects. Two other social science subjects, be it economics, geography, any of those social science or art subjects, all right? You must also have credit passes in those, making five subjects, okay? Then for your university entrance examination, your UTME, you must sit for these papers. Number one, you must sit for English language. That cuts across, right? Then you must also sit for government and other social science courses, social science subjects. What are the career options? If you study political science, what are the career options available to you? The first and the most attractive is the teaching profession. All right, you might decide to settle for teaching at the lower level or at the university level, just like I am doing presently. You could also settle for public service employment. Public service employment. In other words, you could decide to work with the government. All right. Since political science is the study of of power relations, how and other underlining factors to how power is attained and sustained, then working with the government will be a very interesting pursuit for a political scientist. That will be a natural territory for a political scientist. You could also pursue further a course of study in law. All right, I have a couple of friends who, after pursuing political science, have gone ahead also to study law. All right, so being a political scientist gives you a leverage when it comes to furthering your studies in law, and then you could also become a lawyer. You could also become a social worker. In other words, you can get engaged with a non-governmental organization, NGOs, and there are many of those nowadays that pay handsome salaries. So you could also venture into some social work and get engaged with non-governmental organizations. You could also venture into political journalism. You know what political science does to you is to widen your horizon when it comes to information around the globe, when it comes to politics and all sorts. Then you can take that as an advantage, getting perhaps a diploma in journalism, and that gets you into the field of journalism. You could be a political correspondent for a radio station, for a TV station, for a newspaper house, and you can make the best out of that also. You could also be a legislative assistant. You could serve with a lawmaker. You could help in drafting bills. You could help in consulting with the constituents. You could help in all other duties, adjoining duties that a legislator would necessarily do, but might not have the time to do so. You will be readily available to help him do that. All right, and you could also be a policy analyst. All right, and policy analyst will. When we talk about policy analysis, we are talking about those who are involved in critically analyzing the factors, the reasons behind certain things, and then to promote and to postulate how things can get better. So it's very important for you to understand that. What are your natural attributes? What are the things that are expected of you? Then if you want to study political science, we expect that you must have strong interest in current affairs. Things happening around you must be of interest to you. A young political scientist must be interested in the things happening around them, particularly the political environment, the things happening around you. You must be such a person that is interested in what is happening in government, what is happening in to your nation's economy, how the leadership are thriving, are doing, how people are, how political parties are running. You understand? So if you are beginning to have such interest, I would encourage you to come to the field of political science. It will also help you develop a strong writing and research skill. In political science, we do a lot of writing. We write and write and write to convince our lecturers, to convince and to convey our points. All right? So if writing is your hobby, you love writing, you love convincing, you love putting up your argument in a convincing manner while writing, then political science is a place to be. You have to develop such skills. You must also be analytical. We just don't want you to be straight-jacketed. We don't want you to be a one-line thinker. We want you to evolve thought. We want you to look at other areas that people might not even be looking at. So it's very important for you as a political scientist to develop analytical skills. You must be analytical. You must be critical in your thinking. When others are saying there is no way, you must find a way of saying, are you sure there is no way? What if we try this and try that? You must be critical. You must be critical. You must learn to break things down and then to see the possible solutions out of critical problems. All right? So if you are keen into developing these skills, if you are so much interested in the happenings around you, you are so interested in current affairs, you are so good at government in secondary school, and you are looking for a possible course of study at the university, I welcome you to political science and I assure you, you will not regret it. Thank you.